pessimistic.
You're being realistic.
No, but who knows what the numbers will be? What goes up must come down. And as I see today, the BJP was in power in three so-called cowbird states of Madhya Pradesh, Chhattisgarh and Rajasthan. They lost all three. And not many were betting that they lose more than one, maximum two. But they lost all three. So there is a political messaging that it also is symbolic of the things to come. So the landscape is shifting very, very fast. Who knows what the future holds? But I'm saying nobody here is running after the position of Prime Minister or Chief Minister. There has been no Prime Minister of the Adani family for the last 35 years. So to say that he's doing this to become Prime Minister is wrong. He's doing it, I think the Congress Party and he and all of us are fighting for a cause that's far more important than becoming PM or something.
Earlier session, Yogendra Yadav, wearing his sephologist hat, was saying that in the 200 plus seats of North India, that's where this election is going to be fought and won. Would you agree with him?
I'm not a sephologist, I don't know. I think every seat is important, all numbers are important. But the Congress Party has an equal presence in southern India as well as North India. I don't think, but he's right in that sense that the BJP has maximized its presence in all these northern states. And the only way they can go now is south, which is down. Not south here, but they can go down. They are coming nowhere close to anything of an effective party, barring maybe a few places in Karnataka, which I'm sure all of you will help us out in North India. But, you know, Kerala, Tamil Nadu, Andhra, Telangana, it's not happening. They're trying very hard in Bengal for some reason. But even that is going to have pushback.